Well, before the biopic actually came out, Spinderella had some issues. So she was essentially excluded from the production. You know, she said, too often Black women have made meaningful contributions in this industry or left out of historical narratives. She felt that she was silenced and so forth. Salt-N-Pepa actually responded and said, Spinderella was an addition to what was already created. Now, from your point of view, from someone who was actually around everyone, was Spinderella integral in what was happening, or was it Salt-N-Pepa were established and they just needed a DJ?
You know what? If it makes any sense, both can be right. Salt-N-Pepa were established. There was a previous Spinderella.
Oh, she took someone else's name.
Yeah, she wasn't the original Spinderella.
I did not know this.
No. Go to the cover. Go to the first cover of the Salt-N-Pepa Hot, Cool, and Vicious. That's a different Spinderella. That's a different girl. That's a different young lady. That was the first Spinderella. So to your point.
Aha, I'm seeing this. You're right. This is definitely not the Spinderella.
Wait, this is like a Law and Order woman. Bang, bang.
Bang, bang.
Bang, bang.
Okay. I did not know this.
Yeah, did I bust it on you in the car?
Okay, wait. And that album had Push It on it?
No.
Aha, okay.
Did not. So, That's the first album. Push It wasn't on the first album. Push It was the B-side to the single Tramp that blew up. It was an afterthought. Push It was Herbie experimenting, you know what I mean, with a really wacky kind of song that didn't really sound hip-hop. It sounded really kind of clubby. And if memory serves, this is how crazy the record business is, right? It's the B-side of Tramp, which was a huge hit for Salt-N-Pepa. Then this one DJ in Hawaii, I believe it was, he flip it over. He like, yo, I like this song. Some pop station in Hawaii starts jamming Push It, and then it starts popping off. Pop, 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 pop. But to your point, she wasn't the first Spinderella. But they had problems with the first Spinderella.
What was the problem?
Man, I don't even remember, man. It just didn't click, man. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Well, and if you watch the movie, they try to make it like, you know, like, I don't know, like Herbie was trying to push up on her or something like that. I don't know. You know what I'm saying? But it didn't work, as I recall. And they went and they got Dee Dee. That's Spinderella. And she was mad young. She was 16. Mm. So it was almost like, you know, big sister, little sister type stuff. So I think it's both. I think obviously Salt-N-Pepa was established, but, you know, Dee Dee as Spinderella gave them a boost. You know, I mean, you hear on the records, you know, she's on What a Man. People looked for her. So, you know, that's one of the things that just, you know, it breaks your heart. Cause I love all of them. You know what I'm saying? I'm cool with all three of them. I got a relationship with all three of them in different ways. And I love them. And it bothers me. It bothers me that you know, that things went left. But as well as I think I know them, but who knows? There's probably stuff I don't even know that went down or whatever. So I don't know. But I'm happiest when they're all together and they know that. You know what I mean? When I'm goofing off with Dee Dee, you know what I mean? Or I'm trying to make Cheryl laugh, or I'm you know, stealing, not stealing, but sharing the liquor in Sandy's refrigerator. So, like I said, I think that was part of it too, talking about how I was getting emotional during the movie. is because I know where they're at right now. And they're not, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's not like it used to be. And I know that's hard, you know what I mean? It's hard to, you know, I want it to be 1988 so bad. Mm. You know, when we were on their bus, they let us come on their bus, you know, and open for them. So